Hello, everyone. Today we are going to discuss about an event that is going to be free to attend. It's going to be online, and it is organized by Art Classes Group and with the support of Arts Council England. The event will take place in February, half term, and it will include as well activities for Valentine's Day. So plenty of things organized for you guys to get busy during Valentine's Day and half term. So to attend the event, you have to go on our website, artclassesgroup.com, and you need to go on the top bar on our website, news. So there in this section, you are going to see the event, February Online Art Workshops. It is going to start on 13th February until end on 20th February, and it will take place every day 3 to 4 p.m. So it will be 1 hour workshop. Now the entire family can take part in this workshop. However, we suggest for the level of difficulty for each activity, maybe children from 7 years old is advisable to take part, mostly because we are going to use scissors and the more advanced drawing. So just 7+ is perfect. However, if you guys are so confident at a younger age, please take part. So it's going to be run by myself, Marnella Caldarush. I'm going to be your tutor and artist that is going to guide you through all the workshops. Okay, so what is going to be about? On the first day of the this program, on 13th February, we have lily pod painting on heart-shaped cardboard. So just one day before Valentine's Day, we're going to make a lily pond painting in acrylics on a heart-shaped cardboard. This work can make a fantastic gift for loved ones. So for the materials required, we're going to need cardboard, pencils, acrylic paints, and brushes. I just want to show you for the cardboard, so you can use literally A4 cardboard, normal cardboard, and you're going to use a marker just to design a shape, heart shape. Just going to sketch quickly, just as an idea. So just if you can do this before the workshop, sketch a heart with your pencil or marker, and then cut out the shape. Because the workshops are only 1 hour, it's good to have the materials ready in advance, so we'll have the time to do as much as possible. So after you cut out your shape, we're going to start painting. Try to use acrylic paints, the tube ones. We need thick paints, not watercolor, that are mostly water-based. For the brushes, you can use any medium brushes, any size, smaller, bigger. So it's not a specific requirement. Now, in order to attend the event, you have to go press the button buy tickets, and it will take you to Eventbrite website where you can register there. Internet a little bit slow. So it will take you on the main page, and there you'll have a selection for each what day you want to join. Apparently the internet is very slow. However, yeah, that is the step. I'm gonna move towards the next workshop. I need to write again my website. Okay, so artclassesgroup.com, and I'm gonna click on news. Brilliant. The next workshop, Sunday, Valentine's Day, 14th February. Lovely, lovely picture. We're going to illustrate Cupid paintings in acrylics in Raphael style. This, I just love this project, honestly. I thought thoroughly, you know, what to do on Valentine's Day. Something, you know, unique, something amazing. So I thought of Cupids. Cupids are little babies that they represent, you know, the messengers of love. We know some images probably when we were children, babies with arrows, with hearts around. So those are Cupids. They are represented mostly in Renaissance time. And the most famous artist that represented these Cupids is Raphael. So Raphael represented them in very nice, realistic way. So this is what we are going to try to achieve into this workshop. Obviously, we are not going to be able to finish it in 1 hour. We'll complete drawing. And I'm just going to show you only on one face, the technique of how to paint very realistic the faces in the style of Renaissance. For this workshop, it is advisable if you guys can purchase a canvas. Yeah, it will be good to have an A3 canvas or A4, but it's good to have canvas. If not, paper is fine. We will need as well acrylics, so not watercolors. Is a massive difference between these two techniques. So please, acrylics. In relating to the brushes, we are going to use mostly small brushes and try to get soft brushes, so either acrylics or watercolor brushes. On the website, everything is there, description, what materials you need. So please get ready before the event, you know, so we can start straight away with the project. Third project, Monday on 15th February, the same something, children will love this. It is seed art in a heart shape. So what we are going to need for this project, we are going to make a type of mosaic. And the same, we are going to need a cardboard, the same, cut it in a heart shape. So cut it in advance. We are going to need a lot of PVA glue, so not the paper glue, PVA, the, you know, the gluey one, the runny one, and seeds or beans or anything. I have here barley, I have here lentils, beans are very good, any other seeds you can take, cinnamon sticks, anything you can think of. So we are going to decorate this shape, heart shape, with seeds, and we're going to glue them with PVA glue. Very nice. Children really love this. Definitely in your cupboard, guys, must be any seeds or beans left there. I always keep us a spare when I'm too late to go for shopping. So just a few we need, not too much, but diverse. So if you can get diverse things. So it will be, so far, I think it will be really exciting, you know. We will start the project. I cannot assure that we are going to finish. But at least, you know, it will give you guys something to do for the day. And on Tuesday, the 16th of February, for the people who love music, we are going to have an amazing workshop of painting a violin. So we are going to explore the shape of violin, and we're going to paint it on a background with some musical notes. This is a, you know, an amazing project if you want to hang on your walls. And I'm going to guide you towards to the first steps, that is the drawing. And then you can just, from the website, use the picture and just paint it. So the same canvas, if it's possible. Otherwise, we're going to work on paper, but acrylics, very important, not watercolors. the same, everything is on the website, what materials you need. On Wednesday, the 17th February, we're going to have yarn art landscape, something new. The same is, this is mostly designed for children. I think for this workshop, any age can join. And I'm going to show you the type of, we're going to need a cardboard, any size, A4, bigger, it is entirely up to you. We're going to draw with the pencil on the cardboard, and with the PVA glue, we're going to stick the yarn. So any colors, guys, if from your grandparents or somewhere left in the cupboard, anything, guys, even different thread, color thread, just gather together as many colors as you can. Yeah. Anything you can find in your house, thread or yarn, wool, any different colors, even textures will be nice, and we are going to create an amazing landscape. So we're going to give you guys plenty of work for this half term, and you know, you're going to decorate your house in only 1 week. Brilliant. For Thursday, 18th of February, we're going to have a calligraphy workshop. Obviously, the calligraphy workshops, they take quite a few sessions. We're going to do only 1 hour for this. So we're going to introduce you to the materials for calligraphy, and then we're going to create this picture with different fonts for writing. Home is where Wi-Fi connects automatically. I think is the reflects the best the year 2021. We are in lockdown and we need Wi-Fi like crazy. I just want to show you roughly what materials you can get ready. For this, we are going to need paper. We are going to need watercolors or ink, if you have. Now, in relation to the pencils, I'm going to show you what you can get ready. So I have, this is a calligraphy pen. So it is, you need to fill it with ink. You can find it on Amazon. This is a carpenter pencil. It's the best for calligraphy. The same you can find on Amazon. This is a bamboo pen. The same, very good for calligraphy. And probably everyone must have calligraphy pens. So they are normal markers, but they have the nib slightly cut, diagonal cut. If you don't have any of this, and it's difficult, you know, to purchase this from the internet, you can do a trick with pencils. Just use a tape and tape the pencils, yeah? Two pencils. Now, one trick is that one of the pencil has to be slightly down than the other one. So this will help you when you are going to hold it on the paper. It will give you a good incline. Yeah, we need, you need a, like a 45 degree incline on the paper. So you need one lower than the other one. From the website is mentioned papers, pencils, rubber, black ink or watercolor, and thin brushes. I think it's very important to have thin brushes. Very exciting. Many people request us for calligraphy sessions because they want to improve their handwriting or they want to learn this art of beautiful writing. Indeed, it is a special art. And it's very mesmerizing even by watching someone doing calligraphy. So it's nice to learn this art. The next workshop on Friday, the 19th of February, we're going to learn how to paint an underwater scene and realistic bubbles. So for this picture, the same, if you guys can have canvas, otherwise paper is fine. For this picture, we will need, we will actually do the main drawing. We're going to do the bubbles, and we are going to learn how to paint realistically, you know, 3D, to make a 3D effect for the bubbles. This is very difficult, to paint something that is transparent, is shiny, round, is very difficult. So we're going to focus on the bubbles. If you're not going to finish, the same guys, look on our website, take the picture and finish it off after the workshop. But hopefully you are going to leave, you know, the workshop with an idea how to paint realistic 3D bubbles. The same, please, acrylics, not watercolors, because you need a very thick paint. And the last workshop is going to be on Saturday, 20th February. This is an inspiration from my artwork. It's a place where I used to live a few years ago in Camberley. It's one of the landscapes that is very close to my heart, and I totally love it. Now, what we are going to learn from this project is how to create an abstract landscape with strong brush strokes. Now, for this workshop, the same is advisable canvas, if you have. If not, paper is fine. And for the brushes, try to get flat brushes. Let me show you a better one. So flat brushes. We're going to create this landscape only from this kind of flat, large brushes. So we're not going to focus on details. You don't need small brushes, just these ones. The same, if you're not going to finish, you guys can play around after the workshop. Plenty of free time. Try to get acrylic or watercolor brushes, for this workshop. So, guys, if you have passion for art, lots of things to do during half term. Lots of paintings. You can decorate your house with so many things. Just one thing I want to remind you, when you go on our website, please click on buy tickets to go and purchase your tickets. You'll be sent email as a reminder before the workshop starts. You can join all workshops during that week, and I really hope you guys are going to enjoy. We are going to invite everyone to share their artworks on Instagram. Please tag us, Art Classes Group, on Instagram or Facebook or Twitter. We really want to see the collection of your artworks. Maybe take a picture, you know, when you display the artwork on the wall. That would be really amazing from your house. So, yes, guys, get ready the materials. Lots of things to do during half term. They are completely free to attend. I cannot guarantee that you're going to finish the projects in 1 hour, but you're going to start. We're going to learn the main things. I can assure you that you're going to learn basic things in art. And plenty of things. Thank you so much, guys. I'm looking forward to see you next Saturday on 13th February. Thank you so much. And see you guys. See you as well next time for the next interview. Thanks. Bye.